Michel Bernanos was a French poet and fantasy writer, born in 1923 in Fresnes, Palace de Calais, the fourth child of noted writer Georges Bernanos, most well known for his heavy Catholic novels, like Under the Son of Satan or The Diary of a Country Priest. Michel wrote crime fiction under the pseudonyms Michel Talbert and Michel Drouin, in an effort to differentiate himself from his father's established name. His first fantasy novel, The Murmur of the Gods, was released in 1960, but remains untranslated. In 1964, he committed suicide at age 41 in the forest of Fontainebleau. His most well-known novel, La Montagne Morte de la Vie, or The Dead Mountain of Life, was published after his death in 1967 and is the third part of a loose tetralogy, and is his only book ever released in English, under the name The Other Side of the Mountain. The protagonist, on turning 18, finds himself aboard a galleon, signed on for a year as a sailor, a common side effect of drinking too much with one's mates. Awakened by an angry sailor kicking him while still on the ground, he is ordered to go to the kitchen, and because he can't find it within a minute of being woken up, on board of a strange ship he's never been on, the sailors order ropes tied around him, and have him thrown into the sea, and slowly drag him beneath the ship's hull, almost drowning him. Old Toyne, the cook, takes care of him, and makes him his helper, allowing him to sleep in the galley, to avoid the sadistic bastards on the crew. He tells him that the ship is chartered to go to Peru, to find gold for the Spanish, if the English and Dutch don't sink them first. Things go relatively well for 2 weeks, until the ship is becalmed in the middle of the equator. Starving, without water, suffering from scurvy, the men force the captain to let them eat rotting potatoes, raw, as they have nothing else. On the 55th day of their becalming, the crew, armed with axes, breaks into the hold and drinks all the rum that was meant for barter in Peru. The drunken sailors start stabbing and cutting each other to pieces, and when the captain tries to stop them, they kill and eat him for his trouble, devouring his corpse raw. A heavy wind soon breaks, carrying the galleon far ahead, until it is wrecked, and the protagonist and Toyne alone wake up on a strange island. The island is covered in red rocks. They come across no food, but they do find gigantic grottos filled with statues. After a few days, they notice a persistent sound coming from the ground, which very much sounds like a heartbeat. Worse, after a few days, the water they had gathered seems to have turned into blood. The two march on through empty wasteland and deserted villages full of statues to gradually realize the horrid secret of the island when it may be too late. The book is incredible, raw and bizarre, at times reminding me of Arthur Gordon Pym, and despite its short length, I consider it a must-read in the genre.